Imagine a world powered without wires. A world where energy is as abundant and accessible as the air we breathe. This wasn't science fiction. It was the dream of Nikola Tesla. At the turn of the 20th century, others were stringing up copper wires to light cities. Tesla was envisioning a global system for wireless power. He wasn't just thinking about sending messages, he wanted to send the very energy that would power our homes, our industries, our entire civilization. His experiments were legendary, filled with crackling bolts of man-made lightning, strange, glowing orbs of plasma. Tesla's work was decades ahead of its time. He built massive towers like Wardenclyffe on Long Island. He believed they could tap the Earth's resonant frequency. His goal? Make the planet a giant conductor. Broadcast energy that could be picked up anywhere with a simple antenna. His ideas were radical, so far beyond accepted science that many theories were dismissed. He spoke of new electrical phenomena, waves that behaved unlike anything in the textbooks. After funding dried up and his lab was dismantled, many secrets seemed lost. These weren't idle fantasies. He built working prototypes that baffled contemporaries. He could light fluorescent tubes from several feet away, with no physical connection. He powered small motors, he illuminated bulbs wirelessly. He claimed a different kind of wave, one that didn't diminish with the square of distance. This was key to his vision of worldwide wireless power. So, what was this mysterious energy that Tesla believed he had discovered? In modern terms, many researchers exploring his work refer to it as scalar waves. This name can be a little confusing, so let's break it down. In mathematics and physics, a scalar is a quantity that has only magnitude or size but no direction. Think of temperature, think of mass. A vector, on the other hand, has both magnitude and direction, like the force of wind, like the velocity of a car. The term scalar wave was coined to describe a wave that is fundamentally different from the electromagnetic waves we know, like light, like radio. A great deal of misunderstanding surrounds this term. In classical physics, a wave involves a change over space and time, which implies direction. So, the phrase scalar wave can seem like a contradiction. This has led many mainstream scientists to dismiss the concept outright. However, the term isn't meant to describe a wave with no direction at all. Instead, it points to a wave whose direction of vibration is the same as its direction of travel. This is also known as a longitudinal wave, like sound. For decades, Tesla's more exotic ideas remained on the fringe of science, a fascinating but unproven chapter in the history of physics. The puzzle of his wireless energy transmission seemed unsolvable within the standard model of electromagnetism. But then, a modern physicist began to look at the foundational equations of that very model and noticed something was missing. That physicist was Professor Dr. Konstantin Meyl, a German electronics and field theory expert from Furtwangen University. Professor Meyl wasn't trying to prove Tesla right, he was trying to solve practical engineering problems, like why some electronic components failed unexpectedly. Professor Meyl came with a strong background in electrical engineering and power electronics. He was fascinated by the intricate dance of electric and magnetic fields, the very forces that power our modern world. In his work, he often encountered phenomena that didn't quite fit the textbook explanations. He saw strange eddy currents and energy losses in transformers that defied conventional calculations. This led him to question the very bedrock of our understanding of electromagnetism, the famous set of four equations formulated by James Clerk Maxwell in the 19th century. Professor Meyl's breakthrough came when he went back to Maxwell's original work and took a bold step. He proposed a modification to the equations. The standard model describes electromagnetic waves as purely transverse. The vibrations are always perpendicular to the direction the wave is traveling. Meyl argued that this was an incomplete picture. He showed mathematically that a second solution to Maxwell's equations exists, a longitudinal wave, where the vibration is in the same direction as its travel. This longitudinal wave is the scalar wave. It's not something new, he argued, but a lost part of the original theory. Meyl's key insight was to treat the electric field not just as a vector but as something that could also have scalar components. He introduced a mathematical term that had been discarded, Heaviside, Gibbs, who simplified Maxwell's original equations into the four tidy vector equations we use today. Meyl essentially unsimplified them. By reintroducing this term, the equations suddenly predicted the existence of this second type of wave, the electric scalar wave. To truly grasp the importance of this discovery, we need to understand the fundamental difference between the two types of waves. Imagine a long rope tied to a post. If you whip one end up and down, you create a wave that travels down the rope. The rope itself moves vertically, but the wave travels horizontally. This is a transverse wave. The motion of the medium, the rope, is perpendicular or transverse to the direction of the wave's energy. Side-by-side animation. Transverse versus longitudinal particle motion. All the electromagnetic waves we commonly use, radio microwaves, visible light X-rays, are transverse waves. They are oscillations of electric fields and magnetic fields at right angles to their direction of travel. Now, imagine a slinky spring stretched out on the floor. If you push one end forward, a compression pulse travels down the spring. The coils of the spring move back and forth in the same direction that the wave is traveling. This is a longitudinal wave. Professor Meyl didn't just stop at theory, he put his ideas to the test. He constructed a set of demonstration kits, complete with a transmitter and a receiver to prove that his science was real. These kits are remarkable. The transmitter uses a special spherical antenna to generate a scalar wave. The receiver, placed some distance away, can pick up this wave and use its energy to power devices like LEDs or small motors. And it does all of this wirelessly, with no physical connection between the two units. It's a real-life demonstration of Tesla's dream, brought to life on a tabletop scale.